and welcome to St. Elizabeth's. Our first song is Glory and Praise to Our God. Please stand and join in singing.
Good day, everyone. We gather today to worship our God in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him, and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not. so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. You are the Lord.
Our response is, give the Lord glory and honor.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love and endurance and hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters, loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned about anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord. The Gospel this week tells us of the Herodians who tried to entrap Jesus with a question about the census tax. Jesus knew they were trying to trick him with the question, but the great wisdom of Jesus, he answered by asking for a coin. Jesus then gave the great phrase, which we all remember, "Repay to Caesar what is Caesar's, to God what belongs to God." We are called to be stewards of the gifts that God gives to us. It is true that the government deals with many of the issues about which we should be concerned, but it is also true that many are not dealt with, and some not dealt with properly. As a church, we need to step in, and when the issues of concern are not met properly, we need to step in and put forth our funds and support to make sure that these are dealt with. Indeed, we are stewards, not by using our government to serve the needs of others, but also to assist our church in doing the same thing. We have been given so many gifts and talents. We are stewards of these so that the needs of our brothers and sisters are truly met. We pay homage to God for his many gifts in many ways. We could use our talents for the benefit of others by volunteering, or using our talents to support financially the institutions which meets the needs of others. Acts of charity not only benefit the beneficiary, but also the one who gives. The theme for this year's Diocesan Ministries appeal is "Love Your Neighbor." I urge you to consider making a pledge in support of this year's appeal in serving the needs of others. This appeal is a way to be a true steward of what God has given to you. The Diocesan Ministries annual appeal funds the following. The largest percentage of the funds go to Catholic charities. It funds emergency housing and youth at-risk programs, such as drug abuse programs, after-school mentoring, counseling programs, and food backpack programs. It also provides preschool educational programs, early intervention, and specialized intervention programs. Due to the COVID-19 virus, many people have sought assistance with food. In June alone this year, 25,000 people were assisted by our diocese with food needs. Many people have sought counseling, and here in Morris County, Hope House in Dover has provided much assistance. Adults with disabilities have always been a program supported by our diocese. It was started by Father Werlin. There are programs for people with AIDS. Senior citizens are cared for by Catholic charities with Meals on Wheels programs, social daycare programs, and medical and essential transportation. Families' needs are addressed with counseling and social work. Veterans' needs are met with advocacy programs and housing assistance. Our diocese has straight and narrow programs for drug and alcohol treatment. One of the buildings, as you may have read, suffered much damage due to a fire earlier this year, and the fund provided $319,000 to assist in the rebuilding. The annual appeal assists Catholic education in our diocese. Through this funding, inner city schools have been helped as schools with technology, especially with the remote learning which has been instituted during this virus time. educational programs, and support for school activities. The education of our seminarians is helped through this fund, as is Nazareth Village retirement residence for our priests. The spiritual needs of our diocese are met by these two groups of people. Finally, parishes receive rebates of the amount of over half of their parish goal, which in our case is $24,487. Due to your generosity last year, we received over $9,000 back from this fund as a rebate. This is a real opportunity to be a steward of what God has given to you. It will help in many ways those in need. The proceeds of the appeal go only to works in our diocese. They are never forwarded to any other diocese or institution. Your pledge can be paid in installments or at one time. It can be charged to your credit card. Next week, you will have an opportunity to make a pledge here in church. In a recorded message next week, Bishop Sweeney will ask for your help in this campaign by using a provided envelope. Please read the information in the bulletin today and on our website this week, and prayerfully consider if you can make a pledge to be a steward of God's gifts to help others. Remember this, that each day is God's gift to you, and what you do with it is your thank you to God. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. We bring our prayers to God, who hears the cry of the poor, that the church continue to preach the gospel with power and conviction. We pray to the Lord that governments ensure fair taxes and provide needed services, especially for the poor. We pray to the Lord that neighborhoods and at every economic level provide safe haven for those in crisis. We pray to the Lord that those who come to this table be nourished with love, especially those who live alone. We pray to the Lord for those who are ill and listed in our book of the sick, that they may receive the healing power of Christ. We pray to the Lord for those who have died, especially Helen Schiavo, Jack McCormick, and Michael Peer, that they have eternal life in Christ. We pray to the Lord. All-powerful God, everything we have comes from your hand. We return it all to you, asking only for your mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
As we prepare our gifts, please join in singing, "Shelter Me, O God."
Shelter me.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve. Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. To be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most holy, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. When we
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Kevin, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Help us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Elizabeth Ann Seton, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you, Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. 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 At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now offer each other a sign of peace.
Jesus, Lamb of God, you take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is Turn to Me.
Let us pray the Ignite Prayer. Heavenly Father, pour forth your Holy Spirit to inspire our parish community. Stir in our souls the desire to renew our faith and deepen our relationship with your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Ignite us that we might truly hear, believe, and live the good news. Grant us the confidence to proclaim your message to others. Strengthen us that we might go forth and witness to the gospel in our everyday lives. Sanctify our words and actions. God our Father, we pray that through the Holy Spirit, we might begin to make all things new as we seek to transform our parish. We pray that we might renew our commitment to your mandate to minister to one another. We pray that we might be restored to the vitality of our baptism as we accept our mission to go out and witness to the saving grace of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. Through Christ our Lord. Please be seated. As you know, you can put your offertory offerings either in the box in the back of the church or mail checks into the office, or if you'd like, you can sign up for Faith Direct, and there's information in our bulletin on how to do that. We are preparing now for celebration of the month of November, and as we usually have in front of the altar is a book of the names of those people who have died. That book is out there and now, so if you'd like to put any names of people who have died during this past year, please feel free to do that, and then in the beginning of November, we'll have that book up here to pray for all those people. There is going to be a Rosary for Life on October the 31st after the 9 o'clock Mass, which is a Saturday morning. Weather permitting, it will be outside. Otherwise, it will be in the church. Have a good week, everyone. The Lord be with you.
Here.
Now down for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen. May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance toward you and give you his peace. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Our final song is All People That on Earth Do Dwell.